Welcome to WebStylePress. Figma is a design tool like Adobe XD. Download it on PC and use locally, or just go to Figma website, log in and use Figma in a web browser. I'm using Figma in a web browser right now. You can use Figma to create your design and export it easily as PDF without any extensions or plugins. You're looking at four-page PDF design that I have created. Let me break it down. Right now it is 34% view. Control plus, this is 100% view for this file. Control minus, select all, alt shift, and drag to copy all of these layers. Now this right here is a frame. This is also a frame, separate frame. This is third frame, and this is fourth. In this frame, we have got icon, shapes, text, and we have got Google fonts here. We've got this icon in background. And if I click at this frame, I've got this gradient here, radial gradient. I can have linear gradient, solid color, angular gradient, diamond gradient, or I can use image as background for this frame. This frame is also our canvas. So this is simple text, this is text, this is a rectangle. All of these were in this frame. Now while creating a design and exporting it as PDF, you should take care about few things. Use frames as canvas. One frame equals to one PDF page. This one frame. And it is safe to use A4 size frame here. And also export frames as PDF. Don't export group as PDF. You see here frame 1, 2, 3, 4. No groups here. I can select it all. Press Ctrl G. And make it a group. Now this is a group. But don't do that in case you want a PDF export. Frame is like rectangle, but serves like a container or canvas for the design. You can scale up and down a frame just like rectangle. Well, rectangle is this one. We are talking about frame. Also, you get options to choose from for the size of frame. Now let's create a dummy PDF file. Choose frame, and from the design options, choose A4 size. And this is our frame. You can scale this frame. You can have width and height of your choice. Here you can see the width and height, but A4 size is safe here. Let's take it in another page. Cut from pages, press this plus icon, and this is my page 3. Paste that frame here. Now this is that frame. This is the size, 595 pixels by 842 pixels, and I have got few gradients here. Let's use gradient as background. Let's take text 1, 1, color white, font size, bigger font size, let's center it. Okay, so this is frame number one. Let's copy it. Frame number two. Three. Four. Let's change their backgrounds. Okay, if I select all of these frames, it gives me an option here and it says export. I'll have to click this plus button and it says export four layers, and I can select PDF from here. Now I do not want four layers, so it makes sense to just select all of these, press Ctrl G to make them into one group. And now if I press this plus button from export menu and select PDF from here, I can export it as one file. So export. This is our exported PDF file. And there's one white space between these pages or between these chapters. If I go to see thumbnails or chapters, you can see there is one file, there are no chapters. Just one big file. And this is wrong. You won't get the separate chapters or PDF pages in PDF file in this method. You should use export frames as PDF. So from Figma, select all of these, go to file and export frames to PDF. And you will see an error. There are no top level frames on the current page to export. That is because all of these frames are in a group. So do not make group. Keep your frames at top level. Then select frames. Then go to file and select export frames to PDF. Also, you can keep your design files side by side. If we see this new file, it is like this. So you see this proper separation. Now this is proper PDF file. And it has got chapters. Even when these are way apart from each other, you can still select all of these frames and select file and export frames to PDF. And this is the output with proper chapters or pages in PDF. Now let's move to our original design. I have copied this in another page. Now this is same design and it's got four pages. I am selecting all these frames. Remember, these are frames. I used this tool to create these frames. I did not use this rectangle, this frame. So select all these frames, these four frames, file, export frames to PDF. Now this is our output, and this is 100% for the output. And you see this font size, this is 16 pixels. Even 16 pixels is sufficient for 100% view. I can decrease this font size and it will still look fine, because this is like vector. We can zoom in and font will be perfectly readable. So you see proper separation now, and we have got chapters here, chapter 1, 2, 3 and 4. So do not use this export option from here. Use frames, one frame as one page for the PDF, and then select all frames, and then select file, export frames to PDF. Even if you are not a designer, you will need to create your CV, a presentation, or a document in PDF sometimes. There are online tools that offer you images to PDF conversion functionality. You can search image to PDF converter and you will find many online tools. You can use those, but then you have done all the work by creating your design or images. Now taking a PDF output is not hard and you can do it locally. If you have images or files, Adobe Photoshop can create PDF file from those images for you. In Adobe Photoshop, go to File, Automate and select PDF Presentation, select Images and get PDF Output. Photoshop can do that. Online tools can do that. Adobe XD can export selected artboards as PDF. But if you want to have better control, organize designs and files for your PDF and you want to do it for free, then you need a tool with ability to design PDF file and export it for free. My choice for this is Figma, if I am using Figma, or XD, in case I am using XD. For Figma, choose frames or canvas of your preferred size, choose from a variety of Google fonts, create a vector-based design, use SVGs, icons, gradients, and full design capabilities of Figma. Figma is fast, design file size will be small, you can work faster in Figma. Many extensions are available to enhance your design in Figma. There are many extensions available in Figma that can export PDF, but those may have limitation of number of exports, and then you will have to buy the license. But do you need that? So for occasional usage or even for professional usage, use Figma, create designs or pages, export the whole thing as PDF. Your design will be available for you to edit later if you need it. Just remember two things. Use frames. Consider one frame as one page in PDF file. No groups. Don't group images in Figma. Use frames. And then use export frames to PDF from file menu options. And that's it. Alright, like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.